Hello students and my teachers, I am Mukta Nilesh Umak. I learn in class 4. Today I tell you story of tree. One Sunday my family and me go to the forest for wandering. There were variety of trees and small plants looking very fresh and green. We feel very happy to saw the beauty of nature. During walking, I saw one tree is crying. I asked him, "Why are you crying?" He said me, "People are very weak. They cut my branches for their need. I help people give in fruits, vegetables, wood, leaves, oxygen and fresh air. But people never realize my importance. Please help me. Realize my importance among the people. Please don't cut the tree. Save tree life. Save our life. Thank you."
Myself, Kavya Prashant Kachivar. I learn in class 5. My school name is Crayons English Medium School. Today I will tell a story and my topic is a tree talking with me. One day I was walking through the forest and enjoying the scene's beauty around. The sun was shining brightly, the birds were chirping happily, the butterflies were lying across the blue sky. Suddenly, I heard a voice from one tree. "Hello." For a moment, I was stunned and also a bit afraid. Then the tree said to me, "Don't be afraid. I mean no harm. I only want to be your friend." I immediately replied and said hello. The tree bent its branch in way which was meant to be shaken. I shook my hand with the tree and we started talking. The tree told me how it grew from a plant to such a grand old tree, and for how many decades it has been in the forest. I too shared with the tree my life story. I named the tree Babul. Soon I started meeting the Babul every day. Even though the Babul was unable to move the around words, still we had so much fun together. I went to the forest to meet the Babul. I tied a friendship band on the branch of the Babul that she extended to give me a shake hand. But one day, when I went to meet a Babul, she was not there. I was shocked to see half of the forest was cleared, and the place there was Babul stood was barren. I cried bitterly that I lost Babul. Suddenly, a small branch fell near me. I took the branch with me and me to my home and kept it safely in my room as Babul's memory. In my home, I planted a Babul tree, a second memory of Babul. You may have lost things, persons, animals in your life, but you can capture them in your memories forever. Thank you.
Mayuresh Nishikant Deshmukh. I am going to be speaking to you today about e-books are better than paper books. I am telling you many reasons why e-books are better than paper book to be. The e-books are important for us. Why? Because one device, many books. Now its explanation is e-books are portable and lightweight, making it easy to carry around instead of carrying multiple books. Of e-book reader can hold thousands of e-book, which is not possible with paper book. Accessible everywhere. E-book can download and store from later use. One can carry the book around and read them where near they want. Students and all can go through the learning material while at home, and even while traveling, it is convenient people on the go when is not possible with paper book. Easy update the convenient on the e-books are mostly updated anytime. The social feature on the e-books allow sharing and learning of convent when is not possible with paper book can be shared with many people at once. Environment friendly option. E-books are environment friendly. Approximately 2.2 million books are public each year, using around 3 million read their paper print book were to be replaced with a digital e-book, it would save all through tree from being chewed down. E-books are instead no late fair for library. E-books take up much less space and so on. That's why e-books are better than paper books. Thank you.